Hanuman Jayanti is a Hindu religious festival that marks the birth of Lord Sri Hanuman, who is known as one of the biggest devotees of Lord Ram and a Rudra avatar. As we count down the days to this auspicious event, we will be bringing to you tales of Sri Hanuman and, of course, his birth story. This will be presented by Pandit Narad Gosain. Do enjoy. Jai Sri Hanuman.
रावण के लिए भी वैसा ही संयोग आ बना है। मंत्री उससे सुना सुनाकर स्तुति करते हैं। अवसर जानकर विभीषण आए और उन्होंने बड़ा भाई रावण के चरणों में दिनोवर हापन। रिमेंबर इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ रामायण इन रामचित्रमानस दिनोवर हापन अ ब्रदर टर्न्स टू अ ब्रदर ही सेज रावण आप बड़ा भाई हो, यू माय बिगर ब्रदर. But you know what you're doing by kidnapping Sita Devi? You're doing something wrong. Can you listen to me? Ravana, he stood up there with his sword and he says, hey, I'm your bigger brother. Don't you dare talk to me like that. Is that how we think? Is that how people live in today's world? That our brother can't even correct our brother? That we can't talk to one another? That we can't communicate together? That we can't have an understanding? He says, hare, I'm your bigger brother. Don't talk to me like that. काम क्रोध मर और लोभ ये सब नरक की मार्ग है, इसलिए इन सबको त्याग कर श्री रामचंद्र जी को भेद भाजिए. It is said, Vibhishan turns his brother to ask him for help, to tell him, you know what you're doing is wrong. And instead, Ravana walked up to him and he says, if you speak like that again to me, I will behead you. And he took out his sword. You speak to me like that again and I will destroy you. And Vibhishan, बड़ा भाई शांत हो जाए ना. एंड व्हेन ही बेग्ड हिज ब्रदर द ब्रदर रेज हिज फुट एंड ही किक्ड हिज ब्रदर. इज दैट द वर्ल्ड वी लिविंग इन टुडे वेयर आवर ब्रदर किक्स आवर ब्रदर? इज दैट द वर्ल्ड दैट वी लिविंग इन टुडे दैट समबडी कांट इवन टॉक टू अस? हैव यू एवर हर्ड समटाइम्स, यू नो मेनी टाइम्स आई हैव हर्ड इन पीपल्स लाइव्स, मे बी इन अ होम देयर इज अ सिचुएशन एंड समबडी वांट्स टू टॉक टू द फादर और मे बी द मदर. And everybody had to hide and make some story because nobody want to talk to he, na? We afraid to talk to he. Are you a person that is not approachable? Are you a person that is not approachable, that if something happens, people can't talk to you? If two people in a home, if a mother and a father, if two people in a relationship, if two people, my friends, or if people in a home, parents and children, cannot communicate, then what do you have? If a dulahin cannot tell dulaha something that is going on, or vice versa, or if children cannot say, mommy, you know what you're doing, I don't know, no, I can't understand. If there cannot be understanding and communication, then what do we have? Are we waiting just to fall apart? We must learn to be approachable. We must learn to be simple-minded so that people can speak to us. You know, today I'm sitting here doing yajna, and I remembered a long time ago, while doing yajnas and starting Ramayana and so on, do you know at the very beginning of my dedication to my dharma, do you know how many people would have come up to me as soon as I finish and say, Baba, hear this novel, I know you're a little small and thing, eh? I know you now start and thing, but you know, next time you could say it like this, or next time you could read it like that, or maybe you could try this. And you know what? There's something called constructive criticism. If you're open-minded to learn, you will prosper. If you're open-minded to listen, you will prosper. But if you have ego within you and you just want to know that what you know is all that is good in the world, if you're not willing to open your mind to listen to suggestions sometimes, or to listen to a different aspect of your life, then how will you ever learn? There are many people in the world who are experienced. There are many people in the world who may have that mature mind of understanding things differently. There'll be many sages and many saints who would have seen or foreseen our lives in different ways. But if you are not open-minded, you will never reach anywhere. You must always be open-minded in the world. Katha tells us today that while Bali becomes angry, he goes back to the kingdom. He stands up outside and he calls, Sugriv! Ao! And Sugriv heard, are, that's only my brother. But my brother died. Are, everybody come. Something has happened. And at that point, even Hanumanji heard the voice and he came to the spot. And when he came to that spot, looking from a distance, Bali is thinking in his mind that his brother tricked him in order to fight him for kingdom, for wealth, and for money, and Balis powerfully took his gada and he started to beat Sugriv. It is said from the kingdom, at the doorway of the kingdom, from the front to the back, to the rocks, to the pillars, to the trees, he started to beat Sugriv until Sugriv couldn't take it anymore. Sugriv was about to run. And while he's trying to run through the forest, Bali is beating him non-stop. Sugriv has no strength, so we'll simply have to take the beating that he's getting. He can't understand that, hey, brother, bhai, maaf kijiye na. But Bali doesn't want to hear anything. He's not open-minded. He has the ego and he's not open-minded. If you're not open-minded to fix the home, it will never be fixed. And after beating his brother, he decides now, my friends, to run him into the forest. But Sugriv runs in a distance and he holds on to the hand of Bajrangabali and he says, Bajrangabali, only you can save me today. Pavanaputra, I've been beaten and I did nothing wrong. And I need hope. I need a sign of hope. I need strength. Mahavir, please stand up for me. Lord Pavanaputra, you've been sent to save me, not so. You've been sent by my Pitaji. You've been sent by Bhagwan Surya Narayan Swami. And today, I'm asking you to guide me. Please do so. And when he holds on to the hand of Bajrangabali, Jai Shri Ram! It is said with one voice, he throws the gada on his shoulder and he stands up in front of Sugriv. And when Bali came, he stands up and he says, Bali, you don't know my strength. You don't know my power. I am Rudra Avatar. I am Shankara Avatar. I am a form of Bhagwan Shankar. And if you dare touch any part of Sugriv, you will be destroyed. Bajrangabali ki jai! Jai Siya Ram! Jai Jai Hanuman! Jai Siya Ram! Jai Jai Hanuman! Bajrangabali, Pavanaputra, Sankat Mochan. He stands and he says, Bali, please leave from here. And if you ever come back to this spot, then I, Bajrangabali, will stop you. Bali has fear in his heart because he knows that he is the incarnation of Bhagwan Shankar. He knows that Hanumanji is a divine child. He will never cross that spot and that line. And as long as you put Mahavira Swami in front of you, there will be no trouble and there will be no worries. Mahavir Swami, he says, Sugriv, do you remember what you said to me? Bali will never be able to go to Rishyamukh Parvat. Let us go set up in Rishyamukh Parvat. Let us go. Call some of the mandars. Call some of your friends. Bring some of your family members. And let's go to that spot. And they've guarded themselves. And they're going now to stay in this Rishyamukh Parvat until the time is right. They will then prepare their new home. They will live in a cave in Rishyamukh Parvat. They will start their new life. And while they will begin, it is said, Hanumanji will help making sure, he will help Sugriv in ensuring that everything will work out fine. Sugriva Mitraha, the friend of Sugriv, he's known as in that form and in that roop. And while he's known as that, devotees, Bajrangabali, one day, he's sitting outside with Sugriv and they're speaking and something happens now. Lord Hanumanji, he hears something. He hears a sound. He hears the cry of a mother. He hears the cry of a woman. They're sitting outside in the open. The sun is hot. And Lord Hanumanji, Sugriv, they're sitting out in the open. And they heard the cry of a mother. He's looking, he stands up, Hare. Sugriv, did you hear something? He starts to look around, he's looking everywhere. He's looking on the earth, he's looking in the skies. Are you all hearing anything? He calls out to the other monkeys who are there. Is anybody hearing anything? And then suddenly in a minute form from the sky, he sees something coming in the air. And it's about to pass over Rishyamukh Parvat. And when he looks, he sees a woman crying. He sees a woman in tears. And she's crying out aloud. She's taking her bangles and she's breaking them and she's throwing it, the little that she had from being in the forest. She's taking, my friends, little of what she had. She's tearing pieces of her clothing and she's dropping it as though to leave trails everywhere. And Lord Hanumanji, while he's standing there, while this vehicle is passing above, suddenly a little parcel, a little jewelry falls down at the spot. And she cries out, Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jai Jai Rama, Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jai Jai Rama, Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jai Rama. You know what? He stands up and he looks. His heart and his blood starts to boil because he never likes to see people hurt. But he sees a mother in a chariot going and she's begging, Ram Prabhu, Lakshmana. And she's calling for help. He doesn't know, but he hears the name Ram. Ram? Ram, I know that name. He hears the name and he picks up his gada. Are Sugriv, do you think I should go? Sugriv says, you don't know who is that. Why would you get involved? Hanumanji says, I feel something. Something is up. Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama. She has dropped a little jewelry. And when they open the jewelry, they're seeing a little bit of what she has. They're seeing some of the stuff that she left behind. They have this cloth and they have the items. They tie it together and they took it inside the cave. And Sugriv says, Hanumanji, don't worry. Your time will be called soon. Your mission will be called soon. And he stands outside and there mentally he looks at the chariot going. And he says, Ma, I don't know who you are, but I feel connected to you. I feel like you're my mother. I will do whatever it takes to find you. I will do whatever it takes to protect you, Ma. Consider me your child today, and I will not stop until I find you. And there he sits down, and he's asking for guidance. He closes his eyes, and he holds on to the gada, and he would ask for guidance. Lord, where are you? Prabhu, where are you? Lord, I could feel your form and I could feel your energy. Lord, I know your presence is not too far. Lord, when will I find you? Bole, Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama, Jaya Jaya. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Hanumanji sat down and he felt the Lord's presence close by. And there Sugriv says, Hanumanji, be on the lookout. Your time will come. And he starts to pace up and down. If Devi Ma has now passed, I don't know who they are, but I feel it. Something is about to happen. And with this, my dear friends, he sits and he waits, and he waits, and he waits, and he's starting to ponder now. Ram, that name will bring essence to me. I think I can remember him now. Ram Prabhu, as a child, I remember him. And he's remembering holding the Lord Prabhu Ramachandra as a child. And he's remembering the promise that the Lord said to him. And what is the promise? Tomorrow night, we will hear of that. Umapati Mahadeva ki, Bajaranga Bali ki.
Be sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel and find us on Facebook at Sankhya Television.